Hey guys, it's raining outside today pretty good, so that kind of limited what I could get out there and do. And so I was trying to come up with ideas just to get a video up today. And I thought, from watching my most recent videos, it's become apparent to me that I need to maybe start working out a little more again. So anyway, I thought I'd show you my little weightlifting dungeon down here. It's a totally unfinished area of the house, and I kind of took it over with some weights. And I think I'll show you some of the little homemade sort of equipment that I've put together too. And maybe it'll give you some ideas if you're on a tight budget and don't want to spend a bunch of money on weight equipment. So I'll walk around and show you some stuff here. I don't know how good the light is in here, but you can see I got a homemade lat bar here. Just got some ball bearing pulleys on it, and it bolts through a doubled up joist there. Sorry about the lighting here. And just got some heavy duty steel cable on it, and of course it goes down to a little weight stack there. And it sits on a little plate with a rod that comes up through it with a hook on it. And that right there, the plate itself on the bottom weighs about 15 pounds. And you load it up from there. And like right now, because I don't really have anything to hold me down, so it can't weigh more than I weigh or to pull me up in the air. So I got about 195 on there. And I can load it up to my weight, or if I want to go heavier, I can throw a big dumbbell across the back of my legs to kind of hold me on the ground. Over here, this is like a little homemade squat rack. It was made for my last basement, so it's made to fit up in the rafters. And like I said, I don't know how good this is showing up on here, but it's bolted to the rafters in about three different ways there, and then hangs down along the wall back there. And let's see here, it's got like a little, if you can see it there, little piece of steel wrapped over and a screw through it. And that's just enough of a lip to hold that so it can't roll off on you. And just gives you a way to get under there so you can get doing it. Now the funny thing is, since this was made for the other garage and it had lower ceilings, and this basement is closer to 9 feet deep, so I have to actually I had to make a little platform here out of some wood. And it's pretty heavy duty. It's a countertop. And I actually, believe it or not, I get up on there, and I might even show you. I get up on there and get it off the racks, step down, and then do my squats in front of it, and then step back up. I mean, but definitely not recommended. Not very safe, but use what you got, and I've been doing this since I was a kid, and I've never gotten injured, so knock on wood. Here's a few other little weird things here. I don't know if this will show up or not. That's just a steel weightlifting bar that I cut off to size, and I used the collar like a hilt, sort of on a sword, and then I put some tennis racket wrap on the handle. How good that's coming through. And what I use it for is basically to build up your hand and wrist strength. And I do sort of like kendo sword training kind of thing. And it just really, it beefs up your grip and makes your forearms a little stronger, that kind of thing. And that's sort of what this next little thing's for here too. And all that is a couple collars on the end of a short dumbbell bar, and you just weight it to the one side. I mean, it's only got a 10-pound plate, and with those collars, as long as you hold it on the very end and kind of make a hammer-like motion with it, I mean, it'll strengthen your arms up pretty good. Just like levering a sledgehammer, basically, is the premise behind it. And if you got an old unfinished basement like this, you can do stuff like this too. When I set the tripod down, I can show you this. But I just took some 2x6s and screwed them in there real good with a bunch of wood screws, and I can get one hand on each side of these boards and put my head in the rack between the rafters there, and I do my chin-ups on there. and it works pretty good. And I really think you got to have better grip to hold it, because you have to kind of pinch it. You can't put your arm, your hands around it like you can a round bar. So if anything, it makes it probably a little more difficult than a regular chin-up bar. There's another one over here. I kind of have a few of them along here, and you can actually kind of walk across the ceiling like it's a set of monkey bars or something. And then over here has the same kind of deal, except I took these ropes. Let's see here. I don't know if you've seen something like this before, but I took these ropes and I put them through some PVC pipe, and which is kind of, I think it's 2-inch pipe, I don't even remember. And I made it kind of large on purpose, and then put some duct tape to kind of hold them in place. And the rope's doubled up through both of them, so it's real stout. And the rope's good single line weight, 100 pounds. So, I mean, each side of that can hold me on its own. And anyway, I use that to do like parallel bar dip type things. You can hang underneath and put your feet on the bench and do rows hanging underneath. You've probably seen something like that before. They call them ab slings, that kind of thing. And then let's see. Oh. One more thing. I have a pretty heavy duty bench for benching. It's pretty stout. I mean, it's not the newest thing, but it works. But one thing, I didn't have an Olympic bar. So what I did, I took a standard easy spin collar bar from Weider, but their normal collar is not wide enough to fit a bench like this. So what I did, I took the normal collar, I put a steel sleeve in here, and then I spun down an extra set of collars inside here, and then I load my plates, and then I have, of course, another spin collar on the outside. And that was just kind of a little clever way to widen it out so it'll fit my bench and not have my plates banging into the uprights and stuff. You know, again, probably not the optimal setup, but you know, gets the job done, and it'll work till I get me a good Olympic setup down here. And the last thing, I mean, there's more, but for now, man, it's a mess over here. It's like a little workshop over here. I took these little uprights. I think they were for scaffolding or something like that. They're just like, heavy, heavy metal uprights. And I built them into the side of the shelving unit here. And I can put my elbows up on here and do knee raises, or I can do my parallel bar dips on them. And I tell you, parallel bar dips really built the power up on me. And I recommend doing those. Anyway, so that's about it for this video. This is getting kind of long. So maybe I'll click back on and lift a couple weights for you, just so you can see that what I'm capable of lifting anyway. See you later.